What's best, or should we say worse, for muscle growth, vaping or smoking? This video is going to let you in on a secret, but before we get to that, we'll need to wade through a lot of information to determine which is worse. You know, there used to be a time when cigarettes were actually promoted by doctors because of its awesome health benefits. As time moved on, we then learned that maybe we got some things wrong back then, and maybe we shouldn't be promoting cigarettes, especially doctors. Or maybe there was just a lot of money to be made off those little cancer sticks. Either way, we learned that smoking is definitely bad for your health. Thankfully, cooler heads prevailed, and thanks to some big anti-smoking campaigns, it seemed that cigarette smoking actually began to decline. And then e-cigarettes and vaping were introduced. Now we have two forms of smoking to worry about. Now, when it comes to vaping and e-cigarettes in the same matter by which we understand it, it's a relatively new invention. Only being around since the early 2000s, e-cigarettes were originally intended to be a safer option for smokers, and in fact, this was the main purpose for people when e-cigarettes were first introduced. In this regard, vaping has been proven to be an effective means to help quit smoking. Unfortunately, thanks to marketing, vaping and e-cigarettes started to become more popular as a recreational activity. One of the reasons for this is the claims that e-cigarettes are a safer alternative to smoking. However, now that we know a little more information on vaping and its effects, we now know that it's not exactly as safe as we once thought. But is it safer? We'll find out later in the video. But as you could probably guess, neither is actually good for your muscle growth. And you'd be right, but there are some surprises along the way. However, which one isn't as bad? The lesser of two evils, if you will? This video is going to examine the different effects that smoking cigarettes and vaping can have on your muscle growth, and if there's a better choice. So now let's look at these one by one and their individual effect on you trying to build muscle. We'll try to determine which one will have the least detrimental effects. Since smoking has been around so much longer than vapes, we have a lot more research that looks at its effects. Therefore, let's start there, and let's start with what smoking is. Obviously, you know what smoking is, but let's dig into the actual compounds found in a cigarette and the effects they have on the body. Cigarettes are made by rolling tobacco inside rolling paper, which is then burnt so an individual can inhale its smoke. Usually, this is done through a filter, which is meant to minimize some of the harmful compounds. The primary reason people smoke is because of nicotine. Nicotine is the active psychostimulant found in tobacco, which gives people a little buzz from smoking, as well as a sense of relaxation. It acts upon the central nervous system, which provides these effects. Upon smoking, nicotine is absorbed into the bloodstream and causes an immediate release of dopamine, which is responsible for the relaxation and other benefits. It is this immediate release which causes nicotine to be so addicting. In fact, nicotine is one of the most addictive compounds legally available. Now, nicotine is sometimes said to not be harmful, indicating it's just the addictive compound in cigarettes. But this isn't true. Nicotine has several direct effects on your health that you need to be aware of if you're building muscle or heck, if you just like being healthy. But we'll get to that in a bit. Let's move on to a nasty substance, tar. Unlike nicotine, tar is another compound inhaled from smoking, which is 100% harmful. Tar is the residue that is left behind when tobacco is burned and is what makes lungs black. It's so nasty as it contains a good portion of the harmful chemicals and compounds you hear about with smoking. This includes various carcinogens such as ammonia, arsenic, lead, hydrogen cyanide, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, and tobacco-specific nitrosamines. But that's not the only compound you need to worry about. This one also has great effects on your body, carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is a toxic gas that's produced when tobacco is burned and has an immediate negative effect on your body. What it does, it binds to the hemoglobin in the blood, hemoglobin being a protein in our blood responsible for carrying oxygen. So yeah, some pretty important stuff and not something you want to be messed with. As a result of this bonding, carbon monoxide reduces your blood's ability to carry oxygen to your muscles. This reduces their performance and function. At the same time, when this happens over and over, it can lead to tissue and organ damage over time. As you can imagine, this will negatively affect your muscle growth as the repairing and rebuilding of new muscle requires plenty of oxygen and blood flow. But that's not all. Cigarettes contain a plethora of other chemical additives and heavy metals. The specific ones can vary depending on the cigarette, but they all have the potential to result in harmful effects on the human body and your muscles. One of the earliest studies on smoking and its effects on muscle actually comes from 1984. It examined the effects on the muscle morphology of 6 pairs of twins. Each set of twins consisted of a smoker and non-smoker. One interesting aspect of this study was that when it came to overall activity and attitude towards training, the non-smokers tended to demonstrate a trend towards greater amounts, but it was not statistically significant. Well, there is one difference. When it came to strength training, smokers and non-smokers had similar attitudes concerning it. They both liked hitting the weights. However, things change when it comes to endurance training, with the smokers disliking it. You can guess why. But there were other differences concerning the muscle as well. Likely due to the carbon monoxide, the smokers had a smaller amount of type 1 muscle fibers. This may simply be due to less interest in endurance training, as type 1 fibers are more associated with this activity. At the same time, type 1 fibers rely more on the aerobic system, which requires oxygen, and carbon monoxide affects this. Another harmful effect that smoking has on the function of your muscles is the ability to produce ATP due to the lack of oxygen delivery to the muscles. Before we go further, let's look at what ATP is and why it's important. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate and is a high-energy compound with 3 phosphate groups. It's known as your body's energy currency, as it is required to power every muscle contraction and other processes. When a muscle requires energy for a muscle contraction, one of these phosphate molecules breaks away, releasing energy, and the compound ADP, adenosine diphosphate, which has 2 molecules. The problem is that ADP cannot be broken down to release energy and must go through various reactions to resynthesize back into ATP. Regardless of which reaction is used, the ultimate steps are performed inside the mitochondria. Still, one of the reactions requires the presence of oxygen to resynthesize large amounts of ATP. That's the same aerobic system we just spoke about with the lack of type 1 muscle fibers. Again, the carbon dioxide within cigarette smoke actually disrupts oxygen delivery and disrupts this process, mitigating the body's ability to resynthesize ATP. As a result, this can greatly reduce your muscle's contraction endurance. At the same time, even though the aerobic system is associated with endurance training, it's believed that it also plays a big role in helping replenish ATP stores quickly, such as when resting after intense activity. This could theoretically affect your weight training. Unfortunately, there are more issues to be concerned about. Smoking has been suggested to be a factor in increasing muscle wasting and is likely the most important factor a bodybuilder is going to be concerned with. The problem is that there seems to be more than one mechanism by which this takes place, such as carbon monoxide. A major problem is that smoking causes systemic inflammatory mediators, which enhance proteolysis, the breakdown of protein. It also inhibits protein synthesis, both leading to the loss of muscle mass. Still, not only can your muscles then become smaller, this loss of mass could also result in a drop in strength. A 2012 longitudinal study tracked the same individuals over time. Various measurements were taken at 4 different ages: 21, 27, 32, and 36 years old. The measurement we're concerned with is strength, and it wasn't good. Smoking 100 grams of tobacco a week was connected with a 2.9% drop in strength in men and a 5.0% drop in strength in women. Now, there is some good news to all this, as it's easy to reverse, and we'll tell you how in a bit. As a result of all these factors, smokers generally have significantly smaller bodies. This includes lower body weight, smaller amount of lean mass, and even less bone mineral content. Everything suffers. In fact, there was a study that attempted to examine the effects of smoking with the effects of obstructive lung disease. To be clear, they took non-smoking individuals who had developed obstructive lung disease and compared them with smokers with normal lung function. They found that both groups had similar levels of accelerated loss of lean mass and physical functioning. This basically means that if you smoke, you might have the same health problems as someone with an obstructive lung disease. There's also other problems we need to be concerned about when trying to build muscle. Problems that don't have to do with actually inhaling smoke. We're talking about the indirect effects smoking has that can affect your muscle growth. For example, one is the potential decrease in physical activity. Due to the effects on your lungs, many smokers, especially heavy smokers, or those who have smoked for long periods, may just move less. This can result in impaired muscle function. At the same time, smoking acts as an appetite suppressant. In fact, many people cite this for one of the benefits of smoking. This is a problem for those wanting to pack on muscle, as everybody knows you need to eat big to get big. Now, what's interesting is this same effect is seen with those who choose to vape. We mean, take a look at the name of this study, High School Students' Use of Flavored E-Cigarette E-Liquids for Appetite Control and Weight Loss. That pretty much says it all. This study found that 13.8% of high school vape users used vaping for appetite control and 9.3% used for weight loss. Now there will be people who will want to argue that this is actually a benefit and effective, but that's for another video. What we're examining is its effect on building muscle and not eating enough is not helping. So that's the deal with smoking cigarettes, and it didn't look good. Now let's try and take a closer look at vaping. The first problem with judging vaping to the same extent as smoking is simply due to vaping being relatively new. But before we jump into the information we do have, let's first clarify what vaping actually consists of. While different vaping products operate on slightly different mechanisms, the main system involves a battery, atomizer, and the e-liquid. The e-liquid typically contains propylene glycol, vegetable glycerin, flavorings, and nicotine. This e-liquid is then heated up and vaporized by the atomizer, which is powered by the battery. Since vaping doesn't involve the burning of tobacco, people claim that it is a safer option, since the individual is not breathing in the dangerous chemicals. However, concerns have been raised aimed towards the various flavorings and other additives. In fact, there is an entire condition known as e-cigarette or vaping product use associated lung injury that describes a lung injury caused by vaping. A study published in October 2020 reported 2,600 cases and 68 deaths over a 2-year period. Other concerns have to do with the consistent inhalation of vapors. When these lipid droplets are inhaled into the lungs over and over, they can cause irritation, inflammation, and damage to the lung. This condition is known as lipoid pneumonia and is caused by the inhalation of the heated oil. It's safe to say that none of these conditions are going to benefit you when trying to build muscle. Having impaired lung function going into the gym is going to have significant effects on your ability to have a successful session. Weight training is a highly demanding activity, and anything less than 100% function is going to ultimately result in less work done, which leads to less growth. While there aren't a ton of studies on this, there are a few. For example, one found that when given to mice, vaping caused an 11% decrease in running speed and a 30-40% drop in leg force, as well as the inability to recover from lung injury. In addition to the effect on lungs, it's believed that e-cigarettes also disrupt glucose metabolism and contractile function. But that's not all. Unless the e-liquid is nicotine-free, it's still going to produce all of the same effects as the nicotine from the cigarettes. Let's revisit nicotine in more detail. Nicotine use can have both acute and chronic effects, some occurring immediately while others taking years to develop. One of the acute effects is an instant rise in heart rate and blood pressure. What this means is that if you smoke shortly before you go to the gym, your heart rate is going to be working overtime before you even start to warm up. Another major issue with nicotine is its effect on men's testosterone levels. Testosterone is the male's primary sex hormone and has a huge effect on the overall muscle growth of men, as well as their ability to repair and support healthy muscles. It just so happens that smoking will increase your testosterone levels. Well, it might. And don't get too excited, as not all studies are 100% consistent, and the effect can vary. Still, if you're like us, this really took us by surprise. For example, in 2016, a large review was released which examined 28 different studies looking at both men and women. Of those, 22 specifically looked at men and concluded that smokers generally had higher testosterone levels than non-smokers. So how could this be? How in the world would smoking increase testosterone levels? Well, first, we need to separate nicotine from smoking. Smoking doesn't cause the increase, nicotine does. Regardless, what's going on is that when nicotine is metabolized, it leaves over a metabolite known as cotinine. The presence of cotinine has been shown to inhibit the breakdown of testosterone, which ultimately results in higher levels. In addition, nicotine can increase respiration, narrow arterial walls, and increase risk of heart attack. The narrowing of arterial walls can actually be so severe that it mitigates the body's ability to deliver nutrients throughout the body. None of this is good for muscle growth. Now, there is some positive out of all this. There is reason to believe that a lot of the damage possibly done can be reversed after a person stops smoking. In fact, there's reason to believe that any damage possibly done could fix itself relatively quickly. Reason being because much of the detrimental effects are an acute effect of inhaling the smoke, primarily due to the carbon monoxide, as well as the inhalation of nicotine. Therefore, assuming you haven't developed any chronic conditions, such as obstructive lung disease or worse, lung cancer, smokers can get their health to relatively good condition simply by quitting. And as you could guess, this is always the best option. Have you ever seen the timeline of the benefits a smoker gets upon cessation? Well, we're going to show you. Here's a general timeline of the benefits you can experience after quitting smoking. Within the first 20 minutes, your blood pressure and heart rate will decrease, leading to improved circulation and oxygen delivery to your muscles. Wait a little longer and the carbon monoxide levels will drop, allowing oxygen levels to return to normal. This happens in a few hours. If you can hold out for a couple days, lung function will begin to improve, allowing easier breathing with less coughing. In a few more days, you'll be able to taste and smell again and enjoy all that bulking food. All of these benefits will ultimately lead to greater energy levels, which take a few weeks or more. Then over the next 9 months, your body will gradually continue to heal and your lung function will ultimately return to normal. In a year or so, your risk of heart disease will have decreased back to normal levels. Now, if you hold out for at least 5 years, your risk of lung cancer and stroke return to that of a non-smoker, and gradually your health will return to optimal function. Oh yeah, you'll also save on money so you can buy more protein and creatine. But look again at how fast things like oxygen delivery and carbon monoxide levels return to normal. Remember, these are the primary acute mechanisms by which vaping and smoking is detrimental to your muscle growth, and you can start seeing improvements in just a few hours. And remember earlier when we told you about how smoking causes muscle wasting? Well, consistent exercise has been shown to reverse this effect. And if you are smoking, regular exercise has even been shown to mitigate the effects. So, smoking is definitely hurting your muscle health and function. However, smoking and not exercising is making it even worse. So, we don't want to say smoking doesn't matter if you're training because it absolutely does. It's just not as bad. However, we will tell you that if you do smoke, training will still put you in a better position. Still, and we cannot stress this enough, not smoking or vaping is your best option. But if we had to pick which one is better, it's probably vaping due to the lack of carbon monoxide and tar. However, our best suggestion is that instead of thinking about which is worse, vaping or smoking, you should ultimately think about how you can quit and maximize your gains.